वेलकम बैक क्लास टू द पॉलिटी लक्ष्मीकांत. वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द रिमेनिंग आर्टिकल्स इन द फंडामेंटल राइट्स. वी विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द आर्टिकल 20 एंड वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द आर्टिकल फ्रॉम 14 टू 19 इन लास्ट क्लास. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट आर्टिकल 20 विच सेज इन रिस्पेक्ट ऑफ कन्विक्शन फॉर ऑफेंसेस. Means Article 20 grants protection against arbitrary and excessive punishment to an accused person, whether a citizen or a foreigner or a legal person. And it has three provisions. First one is no ex post facto law, which means no person shall be convicted of any offence except for the violation. Except for the violation of law in force at the time of the commission of the act, and nor subjected to a penalty greater than that prescribed by the law in the force at the time of commission of offence. And it is applicable only on criminal laws or criminal cases, not on civil laws and not on tax laws, and it cannot be claimed in case of preventive detention or demanding security from person. Second one is no double jeopardy, means no one shall be prosecuted, punished for same offense more than once. And there is a note that only on proceedings before a court of a law or judicial tribunal, that is for bodies which are judicial in nature, meant it is available only in proceedings before court of a law or a judicial tribunal. And third one is no self-incrimination, means no person accused of any offense shall be compelled to be a witness against himself. Against himself means it extends to both oral and documentary evidences, do not extend to civil proceedings or proceedings which are not of criminal in nature. So next article is Article 21. Means protection of life and personal liberty. No person shall be deprived of his life or personal liberty except according to procedure established by law. There are two cases related to this article. First one is Gopalan case. In this case, Supreme Court said that protection under Article 21 is available against arbitrary executive action and not for arbitrary legislative action. And here personal liberty means only liberty relating to person or individual. And the second case is Menaka Gandhi case. 1978, it has the wider interpretation of Article 21, that is, right to life and personal liberty of a person cannot be deprived by law, provided the procedure prescribed by that law is reasonable, fair and just. And right to life is equal to right to live with human dignity. And personal liberty is equal to widest amplitude, and it covers a variety of rights that go to constitute personal liberties of a man. So here are some important rights included in Article 21, and these rights are right to health, right to shelter, right to privacy, right to decent environment, right to livelihood, right to information. Next article which is added by an amendment is Article 21A, Right to Education, that state shall provide free and compulsory education to all children of the age of 6 to 14 years in such a manner that state may determine. But in 86th Amendment Act 2002, education for all is added. In 86th Amendment Act, education for all added, and it says dawn of a second revolution in the chapter of citizens' right. And we have Article 45 in DPSP, Directive Principle of State Policy, that provision for free education, and now it changed, and state shall endeavor to provide early childhood care and education to his children until they complete age of 6 years, means education up to 6 years of age. And Supreme Court said that in 1993 that right to education, and Supreme Court also recognized right to free education in under Article 21. The next article is Article 22, protection against arrest and detention. Means it grants protection to a person who are arrested or detained, and there are preventive detention and punitive detention. Preventive detention means without trial and conviction by court, and punitive detention means punishment after trial and conviction. Means Article 22 sub clause 1 says that this first part of Article 22 confirms the following rights on a person who is arrested or detained under an ordinary law, and in this ordinary law we have right to informed of the grounds of the arrest, and right to consult and be defended by a legal practitioner, and right to be produced before a magistrate within 24 hours, and right to be released after 24 hours unless the magistrate authorizes further detention. And these safeguards are not available to an enemy alien or a person arrested or detained under preventive detention law. And Article 22 sub clause 2 grants protection to persons who are arrested or detained under a preventive detention law, and this protection is available to both citizens and aliens, foreigners, and the detention of a person cannot exceed 3 months unless advisory board reports sufficient cause for extended detention. And the board is to consist of judges of a high court. And Article 22 also authorizes the parliament to prescribe circumstances and classes of a cases in which a person can be detained for more than 3 months under a preventive detention law without obtaining the opinion of an advisory board, and authorizes the parliament to prescribe the maximum period for which a person can be detained in any classes of cases under a preventive detention law, and it is prescribed to procedure to be followed by an advisory board in an inquiry. And parliament has the exclusive authority to make a law of preventive detention for reasons connected with defense, foreign affairs and security of India. So next article, right against exploitation, Article 23 and Article 24. So we have Article 23, prohibition of traffic in human being, beings and forced labor. This right is available to both citizens and non-citizens, and it protects the individual from both against state as well as private persons. And Article 23 permits the state to impose compulsory service for public purposes, for example military service or social service, for which it is not bound to pay. And there is a term age is not mentioned in Article 23. The term age is not mentioned in Article 23 for the trafficking in human being and forced labor, means up to which age some kind, it is not mentioned in Article 23. And the expression traffic in human beings include selling and buying of men, women and children like goods, and immoral traffic in women and children, and including prostitution, devadasis and slavery. Next article is Article 24, which prohibits the employment of children below the age of 14 years in any factory, mine or other hazardous activities like construction work or railway, and it does not prohibit their employment in any harmless work. And the Commission for the Protection of Child Rights Act 2005 was enacted to provide for the establishment of a national commission and state commissions for protection of child rights and children's court, for providing speedy trial of offences against children or a violation of a child right. So we have now right to freedom of religion from Article 25 to 28. So Article 25 is right to freedom of religion, that all persons are equally entitled to freedom of conscience and right to freely profess, practice and propagation of religion. Means there are implications of rights are right freedom of conscience, which means inner freedom of an individual to mold his relation with God or creatures in whatever way he desires. And right to profess means declaration of one's religious beliefs and faith openly and freely. And right to practice is performance of religious worships, rituals, ceremonies and exhibitions of beliefs and ideas. And right to propagate is the transmission and dissemination of one's religious beliefs to others, or exposition of the tenets of one's relations. Means right to conscience is the inner freedom that he wants to worship which God. It is up to his inner freedom. And right to profess means declaration. He can declare his religious belief in which God he has belief. And right to practice means he can worship ritual and ceremonies and exhibition of any god. And right to propagate means he can transmit and dissemination one's religious beliefs to others. He can propagate his ideas and beliefs to the others also. So right to propagate does not include a right to convert another person to one's own religions. And Article 25 covers religious beliefs and religious practices. There are some exceptions, that public order, morality, health and other provisions related to fundamental rights. And right to propagate does not include right to convert. Article 26 is about freedom to manage religious beliefs, that every religion denomination or any of its sections shall have the following rights: and right to establish and maintain institutions for religious and charitable purposes, and right to manage its own affairs in matters of religion, and right to own and acquire movable and immovable property, and right to administer such property in accordance with law. And there is a difference between Article 25 and Article 26. That Article 25 says about the freedom of conscience and free profession, practice and propagation of religion, and Article 26 says freedom to manage religious beliefs. Article 25 guarantees rights to individuals, and Article 26 guarantees right of religious denominations and to other sections. And Article 25 protects individualistic freedom of to religion, and it protects collective freedom of religion. And Article 25 subject to public order, morality and health, but not subject to other provisions relating to fundamental rights. And Article 26 rights are also subject to public order, morality, health, but not subject to other provisions relating to fundamental rights. So next article is freedom from taxation for promotion of religion. Article 27 means no person shall be compelled to pay any taxes for promotion or maintenance of any particular religion or religious denomination, and provision prohibits the state from favoring, patronizing and supporting one religion over the other. And taxes can be used for promotion and maintenance of all religion, and it prohibits taxation for permission of religion, but not the fee. Article 28 is freedom from attending religious instructions, means no religious instruction shall be provided in any educational institution wholly maintained out of state funds, means not applied to an educational institution administered by state but established under any endowment or trust requiring imparting of religious instruction in such instructions. There are means Article 28 distinguishes four types of educational institutions. First one is institution wholly maintained by state, completely prohibited from the religious instructions. Institution administered by state but established under any endowment or trust, religious instructions religious instructions is permitted. Institution recognized by state. And fourth one is institution receiving aid from state. These third and fourth one, religious instructions are permitted but on a voluntary basis. The next article 29 and 30 are cultural and educational rights. Article 29 is protecting of interest of minorities, means any section of citizen residing in any part of India having a distinct language or script or culture of its own shall have right to conserve the same. No citizen shall be denied admission into any educational institution maintained by state or receiving aid out of state funds on grounds only of religion, race, caste or language. And in Article 29, subclause 1, provision protects the right of a group. It protects the right of a group. And 29, subclause 2, provision guarantees the right of a citizen as an individual irrespective of community to which he belongs. Means it protects the group and it protects the community which he belongs to. And Article 29 grants protection to both religious minorities as well as linguistic minorities. And Constitution of India does not define the term minorities. Supreme Court in this Article 29, Supreme Court held that the right to conserve the language includes the right to agitate for the protection of language. And the scope of this article is not necessarily restricted to minorities only. This is because of the use of word section of citizens, any section of citizens in the article 29 that include minorities as well as majority also. Article 30, right of minorities to establish and administer educational institution. It grants following rights to the religious or linguistic minorities, that all minorities have right to establish and administer educational institutions of their choice, and compensation amount fixed by state for compulsory acquisition of any property of a minority educational institution shall not restrict or abrogate right guaranteed to them. This provision added by the 44th Amendment Act. And in granting aid, state shall not discriminate against any educational institution managed by a minority, and protection guaranteed under Article 30 is confined only to minorities. Only to minorities. But in Article 29, we see that it extend to any section of society, any section of citizen means minority and also to majority, but Article 30 is for only to minorities. So thank you class, we will back with the remaining articles of the fundamental rights.